Hello guys, welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4, the Great War mod is Sunderun. Let's go on with the game. I'm playing World War 1, but as you can see there is the year 1953, and we're still going on with the game, and we're trying to make further advances with the game. As you can see, last time we managed to capture England and Ireland, and this is a great achievement. Furthermore, we managed to deploy even more fleets all over Europe, including right here in the Mediterranean, and I could say now that we're having the supremacy in the Mediterranean, at least. For example, take a look here, we have like 1,000 naval bombers, so here at least 300, and here like 800 naval bombers and so on. So it's just going great, I have to say. And unfortunately, we have a shortage of manpower, so I'm just gonna have to wait a little bit. And we're gonna have a little bit more manpower. We're also recruiting and deploying a lot of divisions that we're actually gonna need, I have to say. They're one of the finest divisions that we can have. And we're also having plenty of material captured from capitulation of England, of other nations, as you can see, and from own industry. So we could make a great use of it, and I'm gonna use it, of course, further. We are producing also a lot of tanks and armor material as well, a lot of airplanes. So things are looking actually very, very well right now for us. Now let's think what can we do furthermore. As you can see, the Axis forces are also getting the upper hand in the Mediterranean, and they are also already trying to invade Crete, as you can see. Which is still going very difficult, I have to say, but I think sooner than later they will manage to capture. There are a lot of division stations here from the Allies as well as here, but they're already taking attrition, so it's gonna be very difficult for them to resist here. Anyway, let's look out for more important things. So more important things, I'm gonna try to deploy even more navy in the North and Central Atlantic and try to sneak into northeastern North America. Also, I'm thinking of declaring further wars, perhaps on Finland, but I think most important on Spain. It would be very important to take Spain now that the Axis have captured Portugal here and they have a lot of divisions. I'm gonna have to be careful, however, because Spain has also a lot of divisions. We're gonna take a look here, as you can see, like almost 300 divisions they have at the border. Of course, we're having the whole continent, so there will be absolutely no problem at all. Not to mention the help from Austro-Hungarians, which are having, like, as you can see, 1700 divisions at least. This is incredible. Now, the thing is that somehow I cannot... I cannot ask them for some expeditionary force. I can only send some expeditionary force, but I cannot ask them for some divisions. Perhaps they could have the initiative and send those divisions. Whatever. Yeah, we have lost here some aircraft carriers, I think, in the past. And this is what Navy is doing, because I think we could deploy them as well. Now, I'm not going to declare war on Denmark because we have a great relation with them, although it seems that they have a landless policy with Portugal and England, so I actually think we should. But we have a great trade relation with them, so right now I'm not going to declare war on them. Now, we're also supposed to have another huge fleet right here that is still repairing, unfortunately. It's still like it takes forever to repair, unfortunately. But we'll wait. That's not really a problem. Now let's increase the speed a little bit. Now, second of all, I was just wanted to show you the fact that we have nothing to research right now because everything has been researched and there is nothing left to research here, unfortunately. It would be nice from the modders to try to make more things to research, such as, for example, in Blake IC or something like that. I think this would be much more interesting if they would manage to do that. Yeah, I'm just gonna check it again, but as far as I know, there is simply nothing left to research here. Three airplanes, jet engines as well. We have a lot of jet fighters right now. Air doctrine as well, engineering, it's everything full researched, and factory as well. That's right. So, yeah, we don't have template for many things, but it actually, this doesn't matter. I'm just trying to increase. As you can see, the manpower is somehow stable. Yeah, let's see. What do we have? Low manpower and unassigned divisions. We also have a lot of unassigned divisions, but doesn't matter. Yeah, low manpower. So this guy with skill 5 should take a rest now. And we have unassigned divisions. Let's see where actually do we have them. It's just only one of them. Stoßtruppen Division. So we have here infantry equipment from Belgium, advanced artillery from Switzerland, and motorized units from Portugal. So it's Portugal from Portugal because we captured during the war with them. Now let's think. Yeah, we could also invade this tiny island here. However, I'm not gonna do it yet. Let's think, what can we invade farther? So as I said, I just want to have control on the whole Mediterranean Sea, and I'm gonna try to go farther into towards America. Now let's see who else actually is part of the allies. Let's see, Tunis, Montenegro, Serbia, Canada, Oman, South Africa, New Zealand, Nepal, Japan, Canada. Who is this? British Raj, okay. Then Bhutan, Australia, Portuguese, Albania, Hellenic Republic, Switzerland, Italy, Belgium, Luxembourg, France, and United Kingdom. Alright. I also thought I could possibly try to invade British Raj right here and launch an invasion in Asia. That would also be great. Because China is not yet aligned, and because there is still a lot of Asian territory to be captured, including Netherlands, Australia, and Japan. So I also do not want to declare war on Iran, because we have an excellent relation with them. Partly because of the trade, I think, but not only. Poor diplomatic relations also, and the same ideology. And we're also having, let's see, a good relationship with Ukraine, so I don't want to debate them, and a good relationship with USSR, I also don't want to debate. Not to mention that we have military access, and they have sent some expedition forces, as far as I know, some volunteers. So I'm not going to declare war on Soviets now. And with these tiny nations, we also have a good relationship, also do not want to declare war on them. I could, however, let's see, we also have a good relationship with Denmark, and I can declare war on them too, but I could declare war on Finland, Sweden, and actually Norway. We are having divisions that are not doing anything, such as these guys here, 24 of them. Otherwise, I just hope I wouldn't have... Yeah, actually, we do have some problems here with Luxembourg. Actually, it's only 9%. No, that's actually okay. It's not growing. So the factories here don't seem to be destroyed. Now, we're also building a lot of things here and repairing, so this is going good. We have some free factories here. Let's see how many. Oh, yes. Oh, my God. Actually, a lot. Yeah, that's okay. Actually, what we need is manpower right now. Of course, I could change the manpower policy. Let's see. So, we have service party requirement. Actually, I don't want to change it. We could opt for all add and serve, but it's going to bring factory output minus 30%. And this is going to mean population 20% instead of 10%. Actually, I don't think I need that, because now it's manpower stable, and we're recruiting 26,000. So we have a great territory. Right, now let's see where else. Wait a minute, I think I had I saw some submarines here. Only two submarines here, okay. I could, of course, send all this fleet here, almost all this fleet, and send them far away into the mid-Atlantic and so on. That could also be something. If I, for example, like to invade, for example, Eastern Canada or something like that. Although I know it's going to be very difficult, very, very difficult to do that, but I could send this fleet right there. Not to mention that some of them seem that I think there are still balance going on here somehow. Or is, yeah, the Americans are still having their naval bombers. I'm not sure how it's possible. And in the meantime, the British are losing, my god, 226 ships, 156 naval bombers, Japanese naval bombers, incredible. Or I could just simply wait until I can have even more more ships, and then I can send all of them. This would also be an opportunity or an idea. So in the meantime, Africa is under our occupation. Now, it also seems that they have a lot of troops there being sent in here. See, these guys here, we're also having a good relationship with them and with Iran too, so the only possibility to invade would be British Raj, and that would be right here, but I'm not sure we're gonna make it. Now, first of all, I'm gonna have to send a fleet here before I'm gonna try to invade them. So, yeah, let's choose a fleet. We have some submarines, and we have here 13 ships. Yeah, I could make a fleet all. No, wait a minute. Yeah, let's merge them. And let's get out Lübeck and Schlacht Schiff 17. Right, and we're gonna have a huge fleet here right now. Unfortunately, we don't have any free emerald, but I'm gonna recruit a new free emerald. And I'm just gonna send him. So this is the first fleet right here. And I'm patrol right here in the Red Sea. Although the Red Sea should already be controlled by us, but I'm not sure this is the case right now. Oh, there you go. This is an Austrian fleet here. Just turning back. I think that the Austrians are already trying to invade somewhere here in Asia. That's why they are moving their ships. And I might also have a lot of, or some divisions, or some armies that, for example, this army here in Italy that is completely, I mean, it's completely unimportant for it to stay here in Italy and defend, because, I mean, there is nothing to defend. Oh, it's also being assigned here, alright. Because this is occupied territory from Italians. And, let's see. Yeah, this is Italian territory, so I'm gonna have to keep it occupied. Now here, they tried to invade, but it didn't work. Now, let's see, Americans have sent a battle cruiser, doesn't matter, we have a better force there. And we have a lot of reserves, I know that, but I just want to deploy anyone because I'm trying to increase the manpower a little bit, first of all. Right, so, let's see, how's naval battle going on here? Now these two emirates, I'm not going to declare on them because I also have a good relation with them. And Russia seem to be in a separate faction, or not at all. Yes, actually. No, it actually seems that they are not in, there are no faction. Okay, interesting to know that. So we have at the border with Russia only one army, but actually we don't need any more. And we're also having this army here. That's good, we should keep it there. And an army that is not doing anything in England, that would be right here. This army here. Marine invasion army. I'm gonna use it to invade. Alright. So I like to say it's either the invasion of Spain. So I'm gonna have to prepare some airplanes here in the southern France front here. The border with Spain. Or Oh my god! Oh! There you go, an American fleet. 13 aircraft carriers. Skill 6. Oh yes, we're gonna have real problems here in Mediterranean. We will absolutely lose everything. Take a look at this fleet. This is gonna be the end of supremacy here in the Mediterranean. And most probably the Americans will try to invade him further. That's why I think I would better leave naval bombers where they are. Although, I just thought they're gonna have a lot of naval bombers here, so... If Americans will arrive... Oh yes, now... Wait a minute. Oh yes, 1200, that's right. And here, almost 500. That's really good. Of course, we will lose all our fleet now. The Turks have come with some airplanes, but this is just nothing. And we're gonna lose also all the submarines. Gonna have no chance at all here. You know what? I think I can deploy... Although I'm gonna need far more manpower if I'm gonna deploy more naval bombers. Let's see, maybe I could send another fleet here. Yeah, I'm gonna actually do it. Unfortunately, we have no free emerald. So that means I'm gonna have to recruit even more of them. Just even one is gonna be okay. So let's send them there. Although I know they're gonna have no chance. Oh my god, look at this. This is madness. You know, the Japanese have arrived here. And they have lost no airplane. ...37 ships in there. I'm scattered. Yeah, this is gonna be difficult. Actually... Now, this is one of our fleet here. But I'm not sure how much it's gonna resist. Oh yes. We're having absolutely no chance at all, I have to say. I lost only one airplane. Oh yes, this is gonna be difficult. This is gonna be very tough. Yet another battle cruiser. Yeah, this is gonna be very tough. Oh yes, we have already lost some more ships. Not sure what the Americans are doing with that fleet. Oh yes, another fleet here. A fleet of submarines. Now, let's see what we have here. I already had some submarines here. Maybe I could send these guys here. Yeah, let's actually send them. Although this is not gonna help much, I'm 100% sure, but you know, let's just what to send them, so I've lost even more ships. They have lost, like, almost no airplane. And they are patrolling with their ships right here, I think that... But this is just an insane fleet. Huge fleet. They haven't arrived here where I have most of my naval bombers. I think they could lose a lot of the airplanes. I could just assign these guys. I'm not quite sure how am I gonna take these guys and assign them here. There's priority. If I'm gonna select them like that, maybe? it doesn't matter. Yeah, that's right, this is gonna be better. And... interceptors there, two Earth superior, mission efficiency 17%, that's right, because they don't have any, they lack the range of it. Oh, here is 28%, somehow is being increased. Let's see how many divisions do we have. Oh yes, we have actually a lot of divisions. However, I'm not sure what this guy's... Oh yes, they are in London. And this guy's are in here. Okay. Gonna take care of it. Oh, let's just send a mechanized division. No, wait. Medium tank division in Luxembourg. Okay, and now let's see, so the Americans, I think they are still patrolling here or somewhere. I'm not sure where they're at, but since they are still losing a lot of convoys, and I'm not sure what they're doing with their fleet. Oh yes, there you go, there is a battle right here. They are patrolling right here, and they have lost already an aircraft carrier. This is good. Although, I know that the Americans are still recruiting a lot of ships, that's for sure. So here there was another huge battle, and the Austrians have lost one destroyer, so there's not a big problem. They're still struggling to invade the Allied forces right here on this tiny island. Yeah, it's still... very uncertain because we don't have the air superiority yet, and that's why it's still... the battle is still uncertain. Whatever, now let's try to send another guy here. Another fleet. Right there. We have a lot of air experience. I think we could also produce some more efficient airplanes, so let's try to do that. Jet fighter B. Let's produce a tougher fighter. So let's see if we can upgrade it even more. 600 TA-152B. It's gonna be right here. And we should produce two of them. Right, and fighter should be out. T-152A. Good. Now we still need some more material, but that's okay actually. I'm also having some air experience. Now I'm gonna produce an even tougher fighter, which is in my opinion great. Let's try to buy some material, maybe I can do so. Right. Austria-Hungary. No, we don't need this anymore. And this should also go down. Now that this tank is here. I'm not sure why is the resistance so high. Local resistance. Occupation policy gentle. Occupy territories. And these guys are also okay. This is another medium tank division. Oh, it's already there, alright. Yeah, an infantry division perhaps will be great. So there are 15,000 men here with advanced anti-air, anti-tank weapons and so on. It's gonna be cool. Alright. Now, let's see what's going on here. The Marines are still sending out of their ships here. Now we're having like... Right. No, they shouldn't repair anymore. Patrol this right. So the guys should patrol even farther. That guy too. Alright. Good. Now... Oh yes, there you go. Another huge battle and... Yet another one. Yeah, they just seem to have... They are invincible here. And just losing some submarine, airplanes from time to time, but we're losing a lot. Just one airplane for like 400. They have a huge efficiency here. It's impossible to deal with them. Right, so, I mean, if I want to invade British Raj, I should think... First of all, I'm gonna have to send a fleet, and I don't have a fleet to send yet. And furthermore, if I want to invade America, I should also... try to send a fleet, but Americans are sending actually an even bigger fleet every time, all over the place. So it's gonna be even more difficult, and manpower is now stable. The only thing I can do is try, for example, to capture Scandinavia and to capture Spain. First of all, I'm gonna focus on Spain. And that's why I'm gonna take this army here. I'm gonna send it right into Spain, at this border with Spain. Right, an offensive line until up to Gibraltar. That's okay. They're in total. That's actually okay. Now we have problem in Africa. Because these guys. Yeah, this is like gonna give even more troops to this man here. And some marines, but whatever, I'm gonna wait a little bit. Yes, so soon I'm gonna invade Spain. I know it's gonna be a bit difficult, but it should work. I would just like to deploy. Let's see, I think I don't have another division that is not doing anything. Now somehow we seem that we don't have any rebellion somewhere in Luxembourg, seem to be okay. Yeah, it's also cool. I could, however, use some guys that... Let's see. These guys are defending Northern Africa. I'm not quite sure. Oh yes, there will be also a problem right here in... in Africa with Spain. I'm gonna declare war on them. Including, where else do they have territory? Here. And right here. Oh my god, they have so many tank divisions and stuff like that. So it means that this is gonna really be a tough thing. Yeah, but I don't care now. Let's see. Yeah, so Catalonia can be okay. And let's see who else could I send to deal with Spain. I have another army here, but it's really very important to stay here and defend, and otherwise, as far as I know, my Paulites send 3 divisions. Yes, actually, let's accept them. This is what these guys are actually doing and how important it is for them to stay there where they are. Oh yes, here. Oh, this is Ottoman Empire. Oh yes, I don't even need this. I can take this guy and bring it all over the border with Spain here and give him some more divisions. Then right. Now he should receive some more divisions, as I said, so let's start with this. Turkish divisions, that's right. And by the time I'm gonna be ready, generating war goal against Spain, these guys will arrive and gonna be ready to attack now. Let's deploy also some airplanes, this is gonna be important as well. World War I bomber equipment, jet fighter. That is 100 of them. Also some bombers. Tactical bombers, level 2, Raptor Zapper. Jet tactical bomber, yeah, this is gonna be cool. Well, close air support would be better, but it's also okay. And there should be another air. Oh yes, here I can actually deploy all of them. Close air support. Scout, close air support too. And actually, close air support. Furthermore. One 71, and yeah, these guys as well. That's gonna be great. So when the war will start, then we're gonna have a huge advantage. Now let's see, we're gonna have somehow some, yeah, we have some more divisions to assign, and of course the Ottomans will have to take care of their territory right here. The Turks are also arriving. Now let's see if something happened here with this American fleet. Actually, we're having a fleet there, that's good. Yeah, it's unscattered actually, and they still have a lot of airplanes. Maybe I should try to send some more ships from here. So this is what we have. We have some submarines for the more, but no emerald. And here, I'm just gonna send even more and more ships, although I'm sure they will not make a big difference. I mean, they will like lose nothing. Oh yes, and so we're gonna have some free factories, so let's try to build some more more things, such as more infrastructure, including in Luxembourg and in France, maybe in southern Italy as well. Great, and perhaps in Africa, I mean, why not? Britain, we actually don't need more infrastructure just yet. Great. More air bases, maybe? More anti-air. Right, okay. Military factory is not what we need. Perhaps a more synthetic factory. And that would be it. Okay, good, and a trench we don't need, castle 4 we also don't need this yet. Now, if you're gonna take a look here, so now we're actually building a lot, this is good. We're also having a lot of factories to build, so this is just great. Now, let's see how things are working here. So, yeah, the guys are arriving per sea. Unfortunately, I'm not sure how they are so stupid. The computer is just so dumb, they need to encircle the whole Africa in order to arrive there. It's incredible. Alright, let's see if we have some more division to assign, and actually we do. So when the war will start, then we're gonna have a disadvantage to attack on all the fronts. No, furthermore, oh yes, we have even less manpower. I'm not sure why or what did we lose, but I think it's just because we're recruiting a lot of divisions. I think that's why. And I mean, if the war will start with Spain, then we'll probably lose even more divisions. And if this would be the case, then I'm gonna have to take a huge army, such as this one from here, and send also here. Although, I'm expecting to get some help from Austro-Hungarians that are having billions of divisions, and they're not using them properly right now. They're not invading them. They're not invading us stuff. So, as I said, right now, an invasion is out of question, because I'm trying to gain supremacy on the sea, and this is very hard because of the Americans. But I'm trying to gain even more territory in Europe and try to capture Spain. This is gonna be very interesting. Curious to see how this is gonna develop. And second of all, after this will be done with Spain, I think I'm gonna try to capture Scandinavia. And if supremacy on sea will be better than I'm gonna try to invade British Raj. Although I know it's gonna be very difficult, but I'm just gonna try to do it. Now there is a Japanese fleet here that is enormous. So these guys just need some more time until they will arrive, that's okay. Now, Spaniards are having a lot of divisions, that's for sure. This is gonna be very difficult, very tough. What the problem is, they have very less territory here, as you can see, and it could capture very quickly. As I said, I'm also relying on the Austrians. They're having here like 40 or 50 divisions, hopefully they're gonna use them. I'm also relying on my air force that is really huge and should also be helpful. And second of all, I really have to have an increase in manpower. I just am gonna have to do something about this. And what I'm gonna plan to do is to gain some of these divisions out, such as, let's see, yeah, perhaps some marine divisions. Right now I'm gonna produce less. The Romanians will have to send 4 divisions. Pretty well, let's do it. I think the Romanians are also puppet, perhaps. Oh yes, that means that I could actually request forces. Oh, they have a total of 4 divisions left. Okay, that's okay. Now, let's do some Romanian infantry right here. And even more forces also there. So it's gonna be ready, expected to finish September 1954. It's gonna take some time until then, but we'll see. The French government will need those troops anyway. I would say that American fleet is simply indestructible, untouchable. No one can mess with it. Oh no, yeah, it seems that they still have a lot of troops here. Now let's see, do we have an emerald? No. However, let's send even more fleets here, and I think I also had some submarines. Yeah, let's send them as well. My god, I have so many submarines here. Now, I wonder where that American fleet is gone, that huge American fleet. 37. Oh, it's right here in the northern. Now, this is gonna be difficult. Also because if they're gonna arrive in the English Channel, then it's gonna be very tough. Now we're having absolutely no chance at all. I'm losing billions of ships. Now let's see what my other ships are doing. Possibly, I could have, let's see, some fleet there might not do anything. Actually, that's not the case. Alright, just what I wanted to check. So if you can select this one. Yeah, they are still, oh my god, they still have a lot of ships they need to repair here. But if I can do like that, and then I'm gonna see it. Actually, we have only better cruisers here, we cannot just... Right, it's very difficult to transfer them. They should leave an option, transfer all fully recovered fleet ships or full strength ships. Gonna be easier than right now, I just don't have the time to select them like that one by one. So let's see again what happened here with our fleet and the American fleet and so on. Oh, there it is. Completely unscattered. Actually, we're doing better with manpower, just a little bit better, which is actually good. Right, I think it's okay now. Oh, and I think that this guy have also arrived at the destination. Yeah, with all his troops, actually some Romanian infantry divisions are on their way. There's also this Turkish infantry division. What they have, 9,000 men. Anti-tank, artillery, weapons, support equipment. But they're actually okay. This is some heavy armor division here, such as armored car division. And light tank division. Actually, I think we're doing good. Yeah, we still need a lot of fighters, that's true. Although we're producing a lot of them, but we still need a lot of them too. This is what we have. Heavy fighters, we have enough. Jet fighters, we actually have an enormous number. And jet strategic bombers, that's okay. Super heavy tank. Yeah, that's also alright. So motorized artillery, perhaps we should need a little bit more, but that's also good. Yeah, so we have at the border this army and I think this army. None of them is being prepared simply because superior enemy 50%. Either we're gonna let them to attack, but then they're gonna receive a lot of reinforcements from Americans and this is gonna be even more difficult. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Even if they are superior and they have more divisions, it doesn't really matter because they really have no chance to take Europe. I mean, if I'm gonna see that they will make advancements here in France, they're gonna send in a bigger army and France they will do it. Not to mention that we should definitely have the air superiority here. So it's gonna be a very interesting fight with Spaniards, with Spain, but we'll see what's gonna come out of it. Right, so I'm gonna have to end the recording here. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, bye bye.